Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Rizauddin B. Rizano, 11DKA, 19F1101.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Adi bin Muhammad Saad, number metric 11DKA, 19F1011.
Okay, Assalamualaikum. My name is Nazrul Aiman bin Nizam, 11DKA, 19F1017 from DKA 3A.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Azari bin Mashuri. I am from DKA 3A, and my card matrix number is 11 DKA 19F1068.
So today we will present about retaining walls in Jalan Parit Panjang, Bukit Baru, Pontian.
Retaining wall for a side Jalan Parit Panjang, Bukit Baru, Pontian. So the layer of this retaining wall have three layers. One is 1.5 meter, second is 2.2 meter, and third layer is 9.7 meter. For BH is 4, UD is 1, C is 37, friction is 5, so the gamma is 12.507. Gamma set is 17.383. Second, UD is 2, friction is 7, C 18.688, gamma 3 is 18.688. Okay, the so the KA1 equal to 1 minus sine 6 divide 1 plus sine 6 equal 0.840. KA2, 1 minus sine 5 divide 1 plus sine 5 equal 0.783. Okay, for the first PA is triangle shape, so it must be 1 per 2 KA gamma 1 Z1. For the second PA is a rectangle shape, so it must be KA1 gamma 1 Z1. Also for the third PA, KA2 gamma 1 Z1. For the fourth PA is triangle shape, it must be 1 per 2 KA1 gamma 2 Z2. For the fifth PA is the rectangle shape, so it must be KA2 gamma 2 Z3. For the sixth PA is P is triangle shape, so it must be 1.1 per 2 KA2 gamma 3 Z3. And for the seventh PA is 1 per 2 KA2 gamma 2 Z3. For the 8 PA, it must be 2C square root KA. And for the 9 PA, 2C square root KA.
First, we have to calculate the value of Y. The formula to calculate the value of Y is PA divide PAY. So that we have to find the value of PA first. The value of PA for PA1 is half multiply 0.840 multiply 12.507 multiply 1.0 50 square, and the answer is 11.819. That is the value of PA1. Next is PA2. 0.840 multiply 12.507 multiply 1.50 multiply 2.20, and we will get 34.67. For PA3, 0.783 multiply 12.507 multiply 1.50 multiply 9.07, and the answer is 142.488. For PA4, half multiply 0.840 multiply 17.383 minus 9.81 multiply 2.20 multiply 2.20, and we will get 15.394. After that, we have to find PA for PA5. 0.783 multiply 17.838 minus 9.81 multiply 2.20 multiply 9.07, and the answer is 126.539. Next, for PA6, half multiply 0.783 multiply 18.688 minus 9.81 multiply 9.70 multiply 9.70, and we will get 327.032. Next is for PA7. Half multiply 9.81 multiply 11.9 multiply 2.2 plus 9.07, and we will get 694.597. For PA8, 2 multiply 37 multiply square root 0840 multiply 9.50, and the answer is 101.733. Next is the value of PA for PA9. 2 multiply 37 multiply square root 0.840 multiply 2.20, and we will get 149.0.209. Next, we have to calculate the total of PA from PA1 until PA9, and we will get 1101.547. Next, we have to find the value of Y for PA1 until PA9. So, for PA1, 1.5 divide 3 plus 11.9, and we will get 12. For PA2, 2.22 divide 2 plus 9.07. The answer is 10.8. For PA3, 9.7 divide 2, we will get 4.85. For PA4, 2.2 divide 3 plus 9.70, and the answer is 10.43. For the PA5, 9.7 divide 2, we will get 4.85. For the PA6, 9.7 divide 3, we will get 3.23. For PA7, 9.7 divide 3, and the answer is 2.23.23. For the PAS, 1.5 divided 2 plus 11.9, and the answer is 12.65. For PA9, 2.20 divided 2 plus 9.70, and we will get 10.8. The total of PAY from PA1 until PA9 is 23,191.272. After that, we can find the value of Y after we get PAY and PA. The formula to find the value of Y is PAY divided PA to 23,191.272 divide 1,101.597, and we will get 2.171. For the next step, we have to find the value of QV. Before that, we have to find the value of W first. The formula to find the value of W is density multiply volume. For W1, half multiply 4 multiply 11.4 multiply 37, and we will get 843.6 kilonewton. For W2, 4 multiply 13.4 multiply 37, and we will get 1,983.2 kilonewton. For W3, we have to multiply 2 multiply 4 multiply 37, and we will get 296 kilonewton. And my friend will continue next step to find the value of QV.
Total QV equal to 3,122.8 kilonewton. QV times X bar equal PAY times W1 X1 times W2 X2 times W3 X3. 3,122.8 X bar equal to bracket 1,101.597 times 2.171 brackets, then plus 843.6 bracket 4 plus 4 over 3 bracket plus 1,983.2 bracket 4 over 2 bracket, and lastly plus 296 bracket 4 plus 4 over 2 bracket. So it's X bar equal to 12,633.17 equal to 4.5 meter. Position of PV, X bar equal 4.5 meter, B over 2 less than X, X less than 2 B over 3, then 8 over 2 equal to 4, 2 times 8 over 3 equal to 5.33. Thank you.
So next, we have to find the bearing capacity failure. So the formula is E equal to B over 2 negative X bar. B over 2 is 4 minus by X bar, which is 4.05. And we get the answer is negative 0.05. Because it is negative, we consider QV is at 2. After we get the value of E, we have to find the PV max and PV min. So the PV max is QV over B multiplied by 1 plus 6E over B. QV over B is 3122.8 over 8 multiplied by 1 plus 6 in bracket 0.05 over 8. So we get the answer for PV max is 404.99. For PV min, QV over B multiplied by 1 minus 6E over B. So the QV is 3122.8 over B multiplied by 1 minus 6 in bracket 0.05 over 8, and we get the answer is 375.75. For the next step, we have to find SF for BC. So the formula is FS equal to QU over PV max. We assume the value of QU is 860. So 860 over 404.99, we get the answer is 2.12, which is bigger than 2. And the answer is okay. Next, checking for sliding. SFS equal to 3122.8 divided by 0.9 over 1101.597. And we got the answer is 2.55, which is okay because it is more than 2. The last step is checking for overtuning. So SFO is equal to 3122.8 in bracket B minus X bar over 1101.597 in bracket Y, which is 2.171. And we get the answer is 5.16, which is okay because it is more than 2. That is all from us. Thank you.